Good day everybody. Today we're starting a series on how to manage or to run GNS3 on the Ubuntu Linux system. Let's start by downloading the latest. Let's take a look and see what the options are. Let's go to GNS3 and Google and see how it points us to the right place. Let's do that. Click on gns3.com and see the options. So you can see GNS3 can be run on Windows, Mac and Linux. We're going to use the installation guide for Linux and we'll see how to go about it. So the easiest one, we are running Ubuntu 24.04. The easiest way to determine that is by running the terminal, opening a terminal and doing cat etc issue. And that'll tell us what version of Ubuntu Linux we're running. There are a few other ways to do this. I won't go into detail right now. But as you can see, we're running a 64-bit as well. I think you can determine that by uname minus a. And it'll tell us that it's a 64-bit Linux that we're running, right? That's a 64-bit kernel. Anyway, we are going to keep this on top, so we can click on the window, right click on this the title bar of the window and click on always on top. And now if we click on one of the sides, the window remains in place. I'm sort of showing how to navigate the terminal as well. So sudo is the do as the super user. That's what sudo means. So we're going to copy these commands one after the other. So I'll do this, and yes, we can add that, copy it, paste it in here. It's going to ask the user sudo password, right? It's now adding that repository to your installation of Ubuntu. Press enter to continue. It does an update already automatically, and you can see that it's fetching it from the PPA, which is a personal repository of some sort. The instructions suggest that we do an update anyway, so we'll do that as well. We don't need to be a sudoer, I think. Oh, we do need to be a sudoer to update. Once you've typed in the password before, it won't ask you to type in the sudo password again. So let's see if we can install this. Now I am installing this on the virtual machine already, so it may give us a little bit of grief, but let's see how this goes. Yes. And now we are installing GNS3 on a Ubuntu machine. We'll see how this goes once the installation is complete, and then we'll probably end the video by then, just by showing you the basics once we've done the initial installation. So here we go. Let's see, should non-super users be able to use GNS3? That's a yes. Able to capture packets? Yes, we will add that. The packet capturing functionality is done through an application called Wireshark. And this makes it possible for you to get details about the packet, including a variety of things, you know, sourcing destinations, where packets are going to, and so on. So I will give more details about what GNS3 can do in the future, but for now what you need to know is that GNS3 is a tool to simulate networks, to simulate on a canvas that will allow you to visualize how your traffic is moving, how you're getting from one place to the next. It's a very, very good tool to learn networking in general, but it's also got functionality and features that make it possible to do a myriad of other things, including building servers and so on. So let's see if we've got a successful installation of GNS3. There we go, we've got the icon GNS3. Loading, yes, run this application on the local server. Okay, so I can take this little tick off here, always on top, So if I click on here, it'll fall to the back. Yes. Let's see. Next. Successful to the local machine. Yes. And now we have a working installation of GNS3.